The Super Asian Brothers. I got a read for you guys on the i9v3 phone, which is an off-scale copy of the iPhone 3GS. It was sent over by ipmart.com. Guys over at ipmart, thank you guys so much. I really do appreciate it. All right, let's tear open the packaging real quick. Very simple packaging. There's the phone itself. We'll get to that later. Here's a USB cord. I don't know what type of USB it is. Take that. Plugs right at the back of the phone. Like so, but get more to that later. An outlet with via USB. Another 900 milliamp battery. I said another because it came with two of them. One's right in the phone and one's right here. Very neat, guys. Alright, I'll put this all to the side and roll my camera down. A little bit down. Okay, there it is. And get the phone itself right here. Let's pop the back open. So we'll see a little red right there. Alright, here's the back casing. They do come in black and white. They don't come in two colors, but you can get them in two colors. Got that 900 milliamp battery. Okay, battery size for a phone. Got that dual SIM right here. It tells you, I don't know what, base and top, but I am using T-Mobile, guys. Dual SIM. Put this back in. All right, the micro SD slot right here. Right there, guys. Alright, let's pop the battery in and turn this thing on. Hey guys, I'm not going to go through all the features with you guys here because there's really a lot to talk about. So I'm going to maybe minimize this to like a 10 minute video. And there is a built-in stylus right here, which is very handy. Okay. And let's turn this thing on. There is no buttons on the top whatsoever. No buttons on the side besides the volume rockers. All there is the volume rockers and the home button. So by turning it on, you have to press the home button. So guys, wait, let me wait till it turns on first, tell you guys this. Yeah, I always hate that music. But guys, there is no flash. I don't know. But there is no 33.5 millimeter headphone jack in here. So guys, that's a really down point to this phone. I'm hoping to get another phone to review that has more features, maybe, and maybe the Wi-Fi and all that kind of stuff, guys. But I'll see what I can do. Alright, let's start right here. You see T-Mobile right there and SIM too close because they do have two SIMs. You can't put two SIMs on it and load it just a little bit more. Alright, slide to unlock. And this is a pressurized touchscreen, so it isn't like the iPhone, which has a heat sensor, so it is a little harder. You put a little pressure on it, but when you get used to it, you know, it's really easy. So I'm going to let this focus real quick. Alright, whatever. Slide. And there you guys go. I'm going to go through some things with you guys here. You got the camera right here, located in the top right. The photos, SMS, QQ, which is like a Chinese version of AIM. Got the calculator here. Profiles, which is just the general stuff. The settings and Bluetooth, I guess, and headsets and all that kind of stuff. Let's go back. Alright, you got the settings right here. Your files, which is where all the stuff are stored, basically. It's all stuff that's stored from the memory card and the phone itself. We got the missed calls, which I see from missed calls from SIM 1 and SIM 2. Okay, we got the IM chat, which I don't know what it is, but I'm pretty sure it's just another IM client. There is. We got the alarm clock right here. We set an alarm. got Java, which is very handy, guys. Java is basically where you can download your games and applications through, because this does support Java. And you got the phone book right here, and we got the right here, which is basically text messaging and all that kind of stuff. We got the call button right here, guys. Let's just type in what's a good number? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Alright, guys, right there. 1 through 10. Call 1, which is the first sim. Call 2, which is the second sim. But I know, I would call right now, but I'm not going to call 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I'm not going to give out any phone numbers right now. Okay, let's press the home button. We got the iPod right here. And this can play songs, guys, obviously, but just in case you guys are skeptical about that, it does play songs. Alright, next page. See, I'm not going to go through all the pages, because most of the pages are actually games that were already built in on here. Some of these kind of hard to see, but this is a stopwatch, guys. You see that? Right there, the stopwatch. So it's a stopwatch, which is basically, you know, a stopwatch itself. Let's go back. It's got the Bluetooth right here. So, you know, to sync your headphone, your headphones, if you have any Bluetooth headphones, and your headsets, and all that kind of other stuff. And ebooks, which are electronic books you can download. This is basically, if you have to know what ebooks are, they're electronic books, which is like, you know, the Kindle from Amazon and the, you know, all that kind of stuff right there. You got the FM radio right here. You got the VideoCon, which is basically just recording videos, guys. Very handy. You got the text, which is just writing out messages, saving them. Basically like notes, calendar, guys. Self-explanatory. MSN. I hate saying that. Okay. MSN, which is basically, you know, if your provider has internet. Since back on real quick, if your provider has internet, you can use that. We got the service right here. We got the call, and we got the playback where all your videos are stored. And guys, I'm not gonna tell you as much about the rest because, you know what, here's the browser too. That's my Mozilla Firefox browser right there. At least the logo I meant. But there are a bunch of games for the next few pages. They're mostly games, and there are voice recording stuff right here and playback where all the recordings are stored. I don't know, this camera focuses sometimes, you know, some other times, but guys, oh, that's the page are just, you know, games, all that simple stuff that are built in games. You can download your own games, like I downloaded Guitar Hero. Can't really find it right now, but I did download Guitar Hero via Java. Alright, guys, and you guys will see the camera out. Check the camera out real quick. Alright, this is the front camera, guys. Let me show you something real cool. Front camera right there. That is the front camera right there, guys. Front camera. Switch to the back camera. Changing. And now here's the front camera, guys. Alright. Here's all the stuff right here, guys. Here's the box and everything. And here's it through this camera. Has a bit of a zoom to it that I noticed a few days ago. I just noticed that it actually zooms, like, it's not the exact picture, because if you actually see it, yes, can't really see this, but it gives a little bit of zoom to it. So, I mean, it doesn't, you know, the quality is still very good, tremendously good for this camera, I would say. And the front camera is right here, the back camera, but front to me. But this camera here is 1.3 megapixels, which is fairly good. The new iPhone 3GS has 2 megapixels, but you know, this isn't the iPhone, so we're not going to compare it to the iPhone. And it also has a front camera right here. Because it's that little hole right there, guys. That's the front camera. It's 0.3 megapixels. If you guys don't know how good the 0.3 megapixel camera is, it's basically a Nintendo DSi camera. That's how good they are, because they're 0.32. And guys, just really, you know, really simple, guys. This is, I'm not gonna compare this to the iPhone, because this isn't the iPhone. All right, I mean, I can get, if you compare the iPhone 3G to the iPhone 3GS, but this is not an iPhone. This is just a clone. Guys, out of my rating for this, 1 through 10, 10 being the best, I give it an 8.5 due to all the features that it has and the features it lacks. What it lacks the most is the headphone jack. That is very critical, I think, to a phone, but it does not have it. So that might be one reason why you don't want to buy this phone. But it has a fairly decent speaker here. It is pretty loud, guys. So, I mean, if you guys want to just buy this phone for, you know, messing around, playing games, I say go for it. But if you're going to buy this for, like, business or, you know, long-term use, guys, look around. Okay, look around, guys. If you guys, you know, just plan to buy this for the fun of it, go ahead if you guys want to. But if you guys use it for business or, you know, everyday use, this is a really good phone for everyday use anyways. But for business and all that kind of stuff, important stuff like multitasking, you guys should look around, right? So this is Dion here from the Super Asian Brothers. Peace.